lockdown has been difficult for everyone, but every cloud has a silver lining. And when Mrs. Turnbull asked me to watch some of your dances, well, obviously I became really excited because I love watching dance. So what has been fantastic is watching your creativity, watching your imagination take flight, but most importantly, watching and seeing how much you actually love dance. So it was difficult to choose any one particular person as a winner, because I can't emphasize enough how every single one of you had something really special. There's so much talent, so much for Mrs. Turnbull and Mrs. Waters to continue to be excited about, because I know they're inspired by all of you. So I would just like to say, great work by everyone.
Okay, junior family dance. I've just been watching them. I love them. These are so much fun. We had the Tweedy family. I love that you got mum and dad involved. The white t-shirt and the jeans combo was really cool, really on point. I like the nod to the 90s hip hop. You were literally jumping around, good energy. Olivia, brilliant choreography. To Little Mix, harmonies for days, choreography on point. I loved it. Gymnastic, balletic. I like that you used the living room space. It was so well timed as well. Perfect unison, technique, floor work, street choreo. It was flawless. There were a few staff dancers in there. There was a bit of dad dancing. A lot of hats. There was a top hat, a fez, a witch's hat, a feather boa, a trumpet. Great prop work. Very creatively framed in the door frame. I like it. There was another staff dance as well that was a lot of fun. A bit of acting as well and changing up the tracks, which was cool. Then the Alan's Mystery Dancer, epic, mysterious. I like these for the keyboard and the lighting changes. That was great. But my winner, okay, this was really hard, but my winner was someone who used a track that I love. It's Super Current. I love a sea shanty. I think we all do at the moment. There was just great partner work with your dad, the Mexican wave and the whale move and the motif that kept coming back every time the chorus played. It told a story with movement. It was really on point. So yeah, my winner is Olive. Congratulations, but well done everyone, I loved it.
There once was a ship that put to sea, and the name of that ship was the Billy a Tea. The winds blew hard, about it down, blow it, bully boys, blow. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. She had not been 2 weeks from shore when down on her a right whale bore. The captain called all hands and swore he'd take that whale in tow. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. Before the boat had hit the water, the whale's tail came up and caught her. All hands to the side, harpooned and fought her when she dived down below. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. No line was cut, no whale was freed. The captain's mind was not on greed, but he belonged to the whaleman's creed. She took that ship in tow. Soon may the whaleman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. For 40 days or even more, the line went slack then tight once more. All boats were lost, there were only four, and still that whale did go. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. As far as I've heard, the fight's still on. The line's not cut and the whale's not gone. The wellerman makes his regular calls to encourage the captain, crew and all. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go.
Hi everybody, my name's Neville. I'm a friend of Rebecca's and I've been involved in the dance industry for quite a long time. I've been artistic director of two companies here in the UK and a company in Zimbabwe, which is in Africa. I've also danced and choreographed literally all around the world and worked with very, very many very well-known artists. And Rebecca's kindly asked me to judge this competition today, which I've just finished watching now, and I think you guys are super talented. It's brought a real smile to me. It's made these COVID lockdown times feel like a real kind of breath of fresh air, actually, seeing young people enjoying themselves, dancing, and being so, so, so creative. I loved your energies, you know, your smiles, your massive dynamics. I loved the fact that you really, really have thought about the steps that you're doing and that you feel very, 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 very involved in what you've done. So congratulations to all of you. You're all amazing. It's a shame I haven't been able to see these live because of the COVID restrictions, but I've thoroughly enjoyed watching them on video. So you're all winners as far as I'm concerned, but I've been asked to choose a winner. And what I'm going to do today is I'm going to choose a joint winner. So I would like to congratulate Rose and Teddy as the joint winners of this competition. You're all very special. I loved everything that everybody did. So in a way, you're all winners. But Rose and Teddy, today, you're the ones that get the first prize. And so congratulations to you both. And I look forward to maybe seeing you all at some point performing live in the future. Keep dancing, keep enjoying dancing, learn from each other, and enjoy coming out of this awful lockdown period and celebrate with your beautiful dancing. All the best, take care, and I look forward to maybe seeing you in the future. Bye bye.
Thank you. This speech is my recital. I think it's very vital. To rock
around,
that's right,
on top of the tricky.
Senior TikTok. I've just watched Let's Start With Jenny. So much fun. The Circle song. It told a story. It was a mathematical story. It was like an education. I learned a lot from that. Lucy, the visual effects, they went so well with the music here. It had this like trance-like quality and quite cool, like intricate moves. I like that it was really gestural in the upper body, this TikTok. But my winner has to be person that got their whole family involved. It was in perfect unison. I loved the costumes. You were perfectly matching. The TikTok moves worked so well. You were coming in and out of that portrait frame. Great focus, great energy. I love Deeper Shade of Blue. So the winner is the Clements family. Congratulations, but it was all brilliant. Thank you for dancing so beautifully.
Everybody, and thank you to all the year 5 and 6 dancers who sent in their videos. I've watched them all. I thought you were all brilliant, and I really appreciate all the effort you put in and the music that you chose and the style that you had. But there can only be one winner, and that goes to Eleanor, who I thought danced so beautifully, so lyrical. Great style and tons of potential. Well done, you were fabulous.
Eleanor Welsh, 5RW.
That I knew why you created me.
for those of you who don't know who I am, my name is Jeff Laidler and I'm the head of the junior school, and I'm by no means a dance expert. You may be able to see me taking part in the staff dance competition, but I've been given the honour of judging the senior pupils' family dance category. So it was lovely to see these different entries, some great choices of music, interesting props. I was particularly interested in one family who it was a cross-generational entry and they managed to all dress in yellow. I didn't know there were that many yellow pieces of clothing around. So great to see people taking part, and dance is such a great way to express ourselves and keep fit. And they've got so many different benefits, so I think a lot of fun was had putting these entries together in these difficult times. So in the end, looking at the entries, I've chosen the family of Amelia, who's in Cuthbert, who danced with her sister. They had great synchronicity in their dancing, they used the floor well, and the one thing that really stood out was the lovely smiles they had on their faces all the way through. They clearly really enjoyed themselves doing this dance. So well done to all of you who took the time and had fun putting your entries together. Thank you.
In a whole other life, there was this boy that I knew. He made me feel like a woman. We were young and silly fools. Anyway, he was in the band. Roll up songs about me. I wasn't crazy about the words, but the melodies were sweet. When someone like do 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 do. Every time we go dancing, I see his strange eyes. Gave him too many chances, pushed my keys too many times. Anyway, he started acting up and I'll be on my way to leave. But I stopped in my tracks when I heard this melody. Anyway, like do 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 do.
The results are as follows. Junior TikTok, the winner was Layla from Aln, A-L-N. And I definitely think she's a future dancer for Beyonce. Congratulations, Layla.
Here we are. And there goes the alarm ringing in my ear. Like somebody said, don't you trust him, no. Texting from his ex, what did you expect? Now you're lying here, knowing where he goes. Now we got that hitch, yeah, karma's gonna get ya. Same way that they come, that's the way they go. Now we got that hitch, yeah, rewinding the picture.
The winner for year 3 and 4 is Layla from Wandsbeck. Definitely a Strictly star of the future. Can't wait to watch the program when she's on it in a few years' time. The winner for year 7 to 9 is Mabel from Cuthbert. She is without doubt a budding crystal pite. And if you don't know who this choreographer is, then you need to find out. And if in doubt, ask Mrs. Turnbull or Mrs. Waters. Special award because there was one little girl who's left a lasting impression on me, and her performance is the reason why I absolutely love teaching dance. She was totally immersed in the music, she was totally transported by her dance and her imagination, and the way that she improvised to this piece of music was quite exceptional. And her choice of costume was also very authentic. And that little girl is Tessa from Tweed. And what I would like to do is to buy her a ticket to go and see Swan Lake live at the theatre whenever it comes to Newcastle or even Sunderland, but probably Newcastle. And after COVID is over, so goodness knows when that's going to be. But anyway, Tessa, well done. You have left a lasting impression on me. So thank you very much. Good luck to everyone.